Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's update is all about the big picture. So I will be talking about the complete peninsula and the capital region as well. And the reason why I'm doing this now is simple. This long chapter of unrest has so far been limited to one volcanic system. And according to some of our experts, this might be about to change. And we might be looking at the beginning of a much more difficult chain of events that can threaten a large part of the capital area. This information has been coming out little by little in the last days, so I have had this video on the sideline while this has been unfolding, and I'm starting the story by the so-called Svartsengi Fagradalsfjall system that we know quite well. It has been erupting 5 times since 2021. And until now, the peninsula has been defined as 6 volcanic systems, but that might be about to change. Next door to this system that we know so well is the enormous Krísuvík system that stretches from the south coast and all the way through the capital region. Then we have the so-called Sulfur Mountain System that includes the so-called Blue Mountain region where we go skiing. And then we have the Hengil system, and the Hengil is a central volcano, or the only such volcano on the peninsula, with a magma chamber. But that is what the geology has been teaching so far, and I think that might be about to change as well. And this is telling us a bit about the importance of the data that the science community is getting now. And of those 3 volcanic systems, or volcanic zones, the Krísuvík system seems to be closest to an eruption. And Professor Ármann Höskuldsson was in fact saying last week that this system has in fact woken up already, and it's only a matter of time when things can get nasty. And this comment was last week. Then during this weekend we got this unusual earthquake swarm around here, and the seismic unrest was explained as triggered by tension changes by the Met Office, or until Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson started to stir things up. He told us that it's likely magma on the move this time, just by the city, and that comment went like a wildfire through all news agencies in Iceland. So the Met Office stepped in yesterday and said there are no such indications, no signs of magma, so just let's stay cool. And since this location is important, just as important as good scientific information, I want to mention how I do my own predictions, which is often based on the performance evaluation of individuals and organizations. Like the Met Office is sometimes a bit backward. If the instruments are not telling the whole story, there is no story. But the Met Office has actually been saying that this change in tension on the peninsula due to the rifting in Grindavík is affecting the rest of the peninsula, and I can totally buy that. It's widespread seismic activity all over the peninsula, way more than the abnormal norm we have around here. But I'm also buying what the professor is saying, that during this displacement period, we might see some magma on the move. That could be the reason for this earthquake swarm. He's not at the same end of the spectrum as the Met Office, and that's why the Icelandic media loves to him, and he tends to get long shots right, but not all the time. Like one of his comments made me drive hundreds of kilometers last summer to film the volcano Askja, when he stated in the media that he wanted the region evacuated. But the volcano Askja, it hasn't erupted yet, and there is no single voice out there with the whole truth. I try to listen to as many experts as I can. And as for this event, is it magma or is it just earthquakes? I'm going to say 50-50. Professor Þorvaldur might be right, and the Met Office as well. And it is a big question. Like, can we get an eruption close to the city, and how serious would it get? So what we have there, where the earthquakes occurred, is one of the largest lava fields in Iceland, telling us that this system is capable of messing things up big time. And I'm swapping now to an aerial photo from the 1980s. It was shot before we built over some of the lava fields that run through the capital region. And we just learned about a study that was carried out from 2019 to 2021, where movements in fractures on the complete Reykjanes Peninsula were measured. And those fractures near Grindavík are no surprise, but those fractures here by the city, they are a bit off. And they have moved up to 5 millimeters between 2019 and 21. And they are categorized as a part of the Krísuvík system, the fissure swarm that runs through the city. And furthermore, they are only several kilometers away from the earthquake swarm that occurred last weekend. So I want to focus on the Krísuvík system shortly before it enters the capital. But luckily, it's mainly the fissure swarm that runs through the city. However, we were also told that the fissure swarm from the Sundhnúkar craters by Grindavík would not erupt within the town. But that is not what occurred in the last eruption, so never say never. And when we look at the big picture again, we find this very impressive cinder cone, but the fissure swarm continues all the way through the city. And this photo demonstrates how poorly situated our capital region really is. Like here we have the so-called Hrútagjá volcano. I've already filmed it, and I'm trying to find time to publish that video. And nearby we have another set of craters just by Hafnarfjörður. And this land here, where lava has flowed three times during historic time, is almost fully built now. So this municipality, Hafnarfjörður, they planned as there would never be an eruption around the city, ever again. And it's a bit sinister to watch those houses being built while I'm listening to geologists say that we need lava barriers in front of them. So it can be hard to watch this nonsense that's going on there. There is still no policy that can be used to prevent disasters like we have been seeing in Grindavík, sadly. And when we look at the land under and by the city, we find this enormous fault, 5 kilometers long, and it has 65 meter vertical displacement. And when I show Icelanders this clip, they tend to say, is this in our backyard? So my point is that our experts have been warning us now, quite gently, most likely too gently, that the things that are to come could be much, much more serious than Grindavík. And not only are we draining our emergency funds now, and they didn't cover this problem, or 1% of the nation homeless, we are adding to the national debt to get us through this. So if this unrest is going to hit the city, it will be impossible for a nation to tackle it without help. So let's look at the third system I was mentioning, the central volcano Hengill. It's further from Reykjavík, but on either side of the volcano there are two geothermal power plants that supply the entire capital region with electricity and hot water to heat our houses. So we have two precious eggs in that basket by a volcano that is rumbling. There is magma at a little depth there. And then we have another problem, and that is air pollution. Like if we would need to evacuate parts of the capital region, like due to gas pollution, it could turn into extreme chaos because the city streets don't even handle the rush hours. And I'm linking to a video I made last year in my town series where I covered a little town north of Reykjavík which merged with the city a while back. The basic idea was to build up that town that has plenty of unused building land and accelerate plans to build a new four-lane highway out of the city to the north, passing this town. But Reykjavík didn't keep their promise. The road hasn't even been designed, and the city, it never grew away to the north from the plate boundaries. Instead, they choose to build on the fissure swarm from the Krísuvík system, which is, in my opinion, a major, major mistake. Or, as I've often said, if we were settling Iceland today using modern geology knowledge, the capital would never be where it is today. And I'm also talking about the earthquake risk. Like, we get a magnitude 6+ every 50 years in the Sulfur Mountains, where we have the thickest landmass on the peninsula. The last such earthquake was 50 years ago. So the bottom line now for this video is that our geologists say that the disaster on the Reykjanes Peninsula is spreading. However, we might get lucky and get some time to prepare, although I do suspect that we have something new on the way soon, judging from the seismic unrest we have seen recently. Or, like Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson was saying yesterday, the Reykjanes Peninsula is in fact just one system. But what we know for sure is that this Grindavík chapter is still ongoing, and it will be so while there is still magma influx into this magma chamber, and we expect the next eruption by Grindavík in only few weeks. So what the civil defense just did was to open up the town for the residents to pick up their belongings, and this is of course very emotional for them. Many of them know that they won't be coming back. The state will buy their property to bail them out, so they will settle elsewhere. So they are not just picking up their belongings, they are saying goodbye to their community. So the former residents, they have perhaps 2 or 3 weeks now to empty their houses before the next eruption starts. And like last time, it's impossible to say where. No one saw it coming, how the last eruption developed. And this has been very hard to deal with this mentally. And as for me, I'm back home now in North Iceland after this long tour. Like always, I didn't get all the shots I wanted, but I got enough to keep my upcoming videos fresh. But I've been putting a lot of work into my updates alone, so I've had to hold back some of my other projects. Not for the first time. But one of my next tasks is for sure to work on my script about the volcanoes around the city, because I've done so much filming for that video already. And after the most recent news, I feel as that video can be very important. And I have two videos almost ready for my town series. One of those videos is about a small village near Grindavík, so it fits well to upload it now. So after this update, I will be pushing those videos from a desk. They have been there for too long time. But I will, however, be ready to take off to Reykjavík again to cover what is to come. Those are strange times, and the next eruption might just as well be a total surprise. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.